Welcome back to Is It Playable? In this video, we'll be taking a look at whether Vexx is playable with Dolphin within RetroArch. Spent a lot of time playing Vexx. Yeah, it's a very hard game. Especially toward the latter half of it. It gets very difficult. But I think I played this on the GameCube. I know I had a demo disc for it, but I can't remember if it was the GameCube or if it was the PS2. But I know it was available on all three systems, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I'm certain it was available on GameCube, PS2, and Xbox. Made by Acclaim Studios. But I can't remember where... like, whether it'll give me access to the area. Oh boy. Oh, Legends of Wrestling. Hell yeah, give me that trailer.
Ours was a sin of-
I don't care about cutscenes. Get me into the meat of the game. If in you please. Can I skip this? Oh, I could. Whoops. No, I can't remember where the demo took place. Mm-hmm. Okay, so B is how you attack. Mm-hmm. Oh, I see. It's a long jump. Yeah. I was doing it the wrong way around. Whoa! Doing with that, blah blah blah. Okay. It's whether I can actually get into the game, or if it's just going to be tutorials. Performance hasn't been great, it has stuttered a fair bit. Which seems to be a very common occurrence on GameCube. I'll allow you to climb. Nice. Oh, now we learn about combos. Now you got the uppercut. The ground blast I already did. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, you could do a... I don't think you can do a triple jump, but you can do a high jump. It's very Mario 64-esque in terms of... Well, actually, in terms of gameplay and controls. Obviously, with you having, like, the long jump and everything. And instead of collecting stars, we collect Wraith Hearts. 100, yep, they've been split into 100 pieces. Kinda like coins. I never realised just how similar to Mario 64 this was, to be honest. But now it all makes sense. It's still a very good game, though. Like, I don't want to diss on... Or I don't want to take away from the game. But it is very similar. Because, like, you have... What? Oh. I know that's a good way of maintaining or getting a bit more distance out of your jumps. No, like, each stage has very specific objectives to get the Wraith Hearts. I'm pretty sure if you collect however many of those, like, skull bongs, it gives you a Wraith Heart. Collecting 100 of these gives you a Wraith Heart. And then just doing specific objectives also gives you a Wraith Heart. But it has its own, like, well, it's, again, still very similar to... Soul Jars, there it is. You get 6 of those, and it also gives you a Wraith Heart. I was gonna say, it also has, like, unique power-ups, but then I remembered that Mario 64 also has power-ups like, you know, the Metal Cap. I can't remember what the hell it's called. Wing Cap, and all those. Whereas this, you can turn into, like, a molten lava creature that allows you to break barriers, or, like, things that are encased in ice. And I don't remember any of the others, I'll be honest. Right, just take us to Demo World. Maybe. Cutscene. Timberdale! Yeah, it does. I remember there being... Oh, you can't... Yeah. There it is. In there is how you unlock it. But you don't get that till later in the game. Oop. I'm just curious if the game's gonna smooth out now or not. Oof.
Welcome to Timberdale, Vexx. Scattered throughout the...
There it is. Yeah, and there'll be a heart really close by. Ah, it's there. But this, you need that, like, red thing in order to get access to it. I remember. What? There we go. Yeah, and each area has 10 different hearts. It's pretty good. I really enjoyed playing this when I was a lot younger. It's still a really good game. But as I say, it gets very difficult. Ba-da-da-da. The worst part is I don't remember where, like, Wraith Hearts are. Because I would have just gone out of my way to grab one of them, but... Might not be that easy. Oh, yeah, I forgot. Fall damage. Oh god. Ooh! Ah, there's a life! I'm trying to just... there. Perfect. If I could find all the soul jars... I mean, I can see there's another one over there. But there's 6 I'd have to find. And I just do not remember where they are. Can I just... There we go. Okay, yep. Actually... Might not be that bad. There's another. It's just, do I remember where any of the others are? The answer to that is, of course, no. What? I keep pressing the wrong button. Oh no, there's one over there. Ooh. Right, so there's four. Oh, there's a fifth. Oh. Five? Okay, I might actually be able to get it. If I can remember where. You know, like, where the last one is. Oh yeah, I forgot about these things. Goddamn. Creepy little aliens. Basically is what they are. And they also don't die that easy. Okay, so where is this last one? I would have hoped it had just been like really close by, but can see that Wraith Heart from a mile away. Huh. Oops, didn't mean to do that. Yeah, I'm trying to remember where the other bloody soul jar is. Unless, no. I was just thinking unless it was underwater, but don't think so? But I also don't remember, well, much of anything, to be honest. In regards to this game, it could be over here. Oof. Oh! Ooh, okay, that was a bit too close. Nice. Actually, yeah, it could be up here. Then again, I don't know. See, not playing the game in years does not help with knowing what to do. I know where certain collectibles are. But we are fairly high up, so maybe.
Race. Crouches. Nearly impossible to kill. Even if you do kill one, the heart never.
Oh, it's that? Oh, that's just a heart. I should have just gone for that one to begin with. If I fall, then that's just gonna be it. But I would like to get a Wraith Heart. Just because. Okay, never mind. Yeah, one of the biggest issues with the game is not really the controls, but hit detection for certain things is very iffy. Can be fairly iffy. Still an enjoyable game, though. Just a shame I never managed to get a Wraith Heart. But oh well. Oh, there's a football! Hang on, I might be able to get the... Maybe I'll get a Wraith Heart if I just take this. There we go. Just kick it over to the goal. God, it does not help that there's enemies everywhere. Go away. I don't remember where the goal was. I like how I can do that. Yeah, just kick it. Ugh. Now, running into it seems to give it quite the boost. That did not work. There we go. Come on. No! God, the bloody enemies. I don't even know what the hell I just did, but I kicked its ass. That I do know. Oh dear. Watch there be a football much closer. Hey, there we go. I got a Wraith Heart. Yeah, honestly, once you actually get in-game, the performance is a lot better. Wasn't intending for this to go on for 15 minutes, but, you know, I wanted to get a Wraith Heart.
A long time ago, the...
Yeah, not bad. Yeah, once you get 5 Wraith Hearts, or 2, you unlock a new one, then 5, then 11, then 18, 26, 34, and then 42. Oh, and 50. Yeah, 50 is the max. Now, the last area. Yeah, it's just like Super Mario. Look at that. It's crazy. It's a much darker story. Yeah, not bad. But I'd have to say that Vexx is playable with issues, I guess. Minor issues. Because it does still stutter. But it only seems to stutter once you're in a new area, and then it buffs out. By the way, that's going to be the end of this video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have enjoyed. If you did, be sure to like, subscribe, leave suggestions for games you want to see, and until next time, take care.